All around the globe, the world is taking a note of India's economic growth. The country has made tremendous progress over the last 10-15 years. As an Indian, it is something to be proud of, to be very proud of, in fact. However, we must acknowledge if there is any aspect in which India or Indians have not moved forward or moved very sluggishly, it is in the field of environmental impact and taking care of our surroundings. The recent shift back towards the use of craftsmen and women who use their hands is a breath of fresh air after decades of mass-produced machine-made products that come off the production line, duplicated in their thousands. As we start today, I would like to take you back to your childhood days, to when you recycled before it was cool. You recycled out of habit and out of routine, from monthly raddiwalas to daily lunch boxes, to glass milk bottles, to using and reusing of grocery bags. Being Indian has many benefits. One of them is to be aware of the magnitude and scope of using an item to its maximum, and then innovating a way to use it even further. I am sure many of us have grown up either passing their clothes to siblings, depending on whether you were an older child or a younger one, or having grown up in hand-me-downs. Even after that, our moms made sure that this was still further passed on to someone more needy. Growing up in our culture and having a knack for design, which of course was a realization much after in my life, it came to me easily to form an amalgamation of the two, which today has become an integral aspect of my design ideology. In fact, the beauty of upcycling is that it comes in many magnitudes. Whether it is inexpensive materials put into the realms of luxury or already luxurious goods given a breath of fresh air, there are many ways, shapes, and forms to the process of upcycling. In fact, upcycling or recycling is something which needs to be a part of our fiber, our thoughts, a natural extension of how we think and who we are. The process of design conceptualization is always in sync with the project narrative. But it is also to be able to breathe, to integrate, and to repurpose material is a parallel process. When we sit as a team and ideate, at that point, we try to incorporate your day-to-day used products or go scavenger hunting and then deviate or redefine the narrative. It can't be a hardline process. It has to be fun. And the end product has to work with the design brief. When it comes to restaurant interiors, there is a fine line between keeping it upcycle and fun to overdoing it. The balance is the key, which is the essence of our everyday design. Bombay Bronx is a project. It's in Pune and Mumbai. The Bombay Bronx, as the name suggests, is trying to capture the never-die spirit of Bombay, from the iconic Dabbawalas and train systems to the Bollywood dreamland. When we were designing, the idea was to try and touch upon all the iconic points that correlate and take us back to Mumbai.